Hello, everybody, and thank you for stopping by. Now, I have said, if you go back to my video about never grocery shop again, or don't grocery shop again, I can't remember the exact name, but I show how I don't grocery shop. I have turned myself into my own little miniature personal grocery store, and I explained in that video exactly how I done it. And I did it strictly from change. And so it's a very, very informative video, and I hope you'll go back and watch it. But today I'm going to show you something that I purchased. Now, at Christmas time, I make tamales, okay? So I'm always looking for the meat on sale. And this is the meat that you make the tamales from. It's from pork butt. Tamales are made from the pork butt roast. The pork tamales are. It's a little fattier, and it just has a far better flavor for tamales. But pork butt here runs around two something a pound. And I got it for 88 cents a pound. Now, this is August, I think the 21st or 22nd. I don't know the exact date. I think it's the 22nd. But I look for things ahead of time. I know Christmas isn't until December, and that's like 4 months away, but I'm always looking ahead. That's part of the prepper in me, that's always thinking ahead, wanting to make sure that I have everything I need for the future. And I need this to make the tamales, and I'm looking to get it at the best price possible. And as you can see on this, this is 88 cents a pound. This is 17 point something pounds. Now, I'm not going to use all this. I'm not going to use 17 pounds of pork for tamales. That's a lot of pork, and it's not needed. But I will give you a little tip, a little secret here. A lot of you may like pork steak, and pork pork steak is made from the butt of pork. Now, pork steak is very, very expensive, very expensive. I'm not talking pork chops. Pork steak is different than pork chops. It's a totally different cut, and pork chops are much leaner. I don't like them. I find them to be dry. And on occasion, I do like to have what I call a battered fried pork steak. And that's where you dip it in some egg wash. And then you dip it in some seasoned flour, which my seasoned flour is just usually salt and pepper. And I'll dip the pork steak in the egg wash, then in the flour on both sides. It's seasoned good with salt and pepper. And then I will put a fairly nice amount of oil or lard, whatever you use, whatever cooking fat you use. I'll put a fair amount. I'm not deep frying it, okay? I know some people who do, but I don't. I just brown it real good on one side, and then flip it and brown it real good on the other side until it's done. And this is the cut of meat that makes the steak. Now, that's pretty darn cheap for pork steak, 88 cents a pound. There are two butt roasts in this. They're called Boston. Here they just put it's a pork butt roast, and it has two. But they're called a Boston butt pork roast in a lot of stores. That's how they label them, as a Boston butt pork roast, not shoulder. Shoulder roast, I don't like them. They've had them as cheap as 49 cents here. And I have to be honest, I would really have to be starving to eat them. They are dry and tough. I just don't like them. Now, if they're cured, if you have a smoker and can cure them, which I don't have. I don't have one of those nice, you know, built smokers that you can smoke meat. They're very good smoked. When I used to raise pigs, that's what I did. We had a man that lived in the area that had a really professional smoker, and he only charged me a few dollars to smoke my shoulders, and they were delicious that way. Now, they had to be kept in the freezer. They weren't salt cured and smoked. He just took them and smoked them for me, and they were delicious that way. But just fresh, I don't like them at all. They're just too dry and too tough, and I just don't care for them. But pork roast is delicious, and it's very good, and it's very good in tamales. And like I said, this is also pork steak. Now, there is two of these in here. It's two. One of them I'm going to turn into pork steak in December. When I finally unthaw this completely, I had to take it out of the freezer to show you this because I got it a couple of days ago, came home and was doing other things and stuck it in the freezer and said, oh, I'll make a video on it later. And I don't really do grocery hauls because, a lot of people will do videos on grocery hauls, and I really don't do that because I don't really grocery shop. I just replace what I use, like, a few canned greens, a few canned sweet peas, or, maybe some carrots or something. I don't really do a lot of grocery shopping. Now, I did get a 50-pound bag of flour and another 25-pound bucket of lard. Where I get it from is a restaurant supply store. I will not get a membership from like Sam's Club or Costco because you have to pay for those. And unless you do an enormous amount of shopping there, it's not worth it. I don't do a lot of shopping there because, like I said, I buy all my canned goods only when they're on sale. And they don't put, even their name brand, they don't put it on sale. You're going to pay full price for it, so I'm not interested. When it comes to other things, I've heard people, well, I get tires there, batteries there. There's lots of places that have good sales on tires and batteries and other things. So I personally don't shop those places because I refuse to pay the membership behind it. And we did discover a restaurant supply place here that does not charge you anything, and you do not have to have a restaurant to shop there. It's open to the public, and they give you a card. And if they have something on a special price there, if you have that card, you get the sale price on it. And I can get a 50-pound bag of flour there cheaper than I can buy two 25-pound bags at the store on sale. That's when I find them on sale. I can go in there and get a 50-pound bag cheaper than what I find at the stores when the flour is on sale. And so I buy my flour from there, and the same with my lard. I get it from there for the same reason. I can get it cheaper than I can get it on the store, even when it's on sale. And so there's some things that, like I said, flour, and I get my rice there too because it's much cheaper. My beans, I don't. I have a store here that puts 20-pound bag of beans on sale all the time for $6.99, so I get them from that store. And you got to shop around and really look and hunt. Look and see if there's a restaurant supply place in your town and see. I get butter from this restaurant supply place. It's much cheaper than the grocery store, even when the grocery store has it on sale. So you got to kind of look around in your area, see if there is a restaurant supply place that does not require you to have to pay for a membership card. I got 3 gallons of ice cream, chocolate ice cream there, for the price that I would pay for two at the grocery store. So I got myself 3 gallons of chocolate ice cream, and I put it in my deep freeze. And it is much cheaper than what I would have gotten for 2 gallons at the store. So you gotta look around, you gotta check places. But like I said, on this, and this is what I was talking about, for the pork steak, you can cut it either with a meat saw, hand meat saw, which we have. But we also have what they call a Sawzall. It's long, and you put a long blade in it, and it makes cutting meat a breeze. Now, we use the handsaw too, combination of the both. You do not want to try to cut meat when it's fresh from the store. It's just too soft, and it's just really hard to cut, and it's messy to cut. You don't want to try to cut it when it's frozen solid, like this meat is frozen. You want to cut it when it is partially frozen, firm and partially frozen. I'd say about halfway. So when I take this out for the tamales and defrost it, I will take out also the other portion to make the pork steak. And I want it partially frozen to cut it. That is the easiest way to cut meat. There's a lot of cuts out there that are combined with other, cuts that they sell, and it's actually connected to it. I mean, like pork steak, this is pork steak, but it's in a roast. And pork steak is extremely expensive here. And here you have pork steak for 88 cents a pound. Hope you find that tip helpful. Maybe look up some of the meats and see. I was fortunate enough, my Nutter Butter used to work in a meat, cutting meat. He was a meat cutter, so he knows how to cut up meat. He knows what cuts of meat come from what parts of the animals, so that was helpful to us, and it made it easier for us also. You know, a lot of people raise their animals and then they ship them off to their local places where they, you know, pack them, slaughter them, and it's very expensive. In the end, they really don't save any money. My brother raises pigs, and he told me he quit doing it because he said by the time he took it and they cut it and packaged it and shipped it back home to him, you know, he went to go pick it up. A lot of times he said he felt that he was cheated, that they stole some of the meat. He said he couldn't prove it, but he really believed they did because most of those places who do that kind of thing also sell fresh meat themselves there. And he said it just cost him as much, if not more, to go to the store and buy it, so he quit doing that. But when you raise an animal yourself and you do the slaughtering and you do the cutting and you do the packaging, it saves you an awesome amount of money. Now, goat meat in my area is already expensive. It's more than $8 a pound at the store if you can find it. That's a lot of money to pay per pound, and I'm getting it for less than $2 a pound at home. So it's well worth it. But remember, I do all the packaging and cutting, and we do the slaughtering ourselves. I hope you found this information helpful. Sorry I didn't have some huge haul, grocery haul, and I could show you all the savings that I get. But like I said, I really don't do that. You know, like when I find it on sale, I replace because I stocked my shelves a long time ago. I just finished stocking the last part of it this last few weeks. But if you want to see how I did it, go back to Don't Ever Shop or Grocery Shop Again, and you will see how I did it. And God bless you, and may you have a blessed day.